NASA's new rocket, the Space Launch System, is building on the foundation laid by the Saturn V and the Space Shuttle. In fact, its current design looks a little bit like a mashup of the Saturn V and the Space Shuttle. That's because it's taking technology from both and combining them to go further than they ever could.
That's one small step for man.
Traveling through space is hard. That's why NASA's Space Launch System will have to be the most powerful rocket in history. How is SLS able to meet the challenges of exploring deep space? Well, when it comes to our journey to Mars and beyond, there are no small steps.
Let's talk about how the SLS is like the Saturn V. The SLS is a staged rocket like the Saturn V. Once all of the fuel in a stage is used up, that stage is dropped to reduce weight. The two are also similar heights. The first version of the SLS will be 322 feet compared to 360 feet for the Saturn V. Now the Saturn V had three inline stages where the SLS will only have two. But the SLS does have two boosters on either side, and you know where those came from. The Space Shuttle's solid rocket boosters produce the most thrust of any rocket engine in history. The SLS will use the same boosters, but they'll be even more powerful because they have an extra fifth segment containing propellant. The SLS's two boosters combined will produce almost as much thrust as all five of the Saturn V first stage engines. The SLS is also using the Space Shuttle's main engines, four of them at the bottom of the center of the rocket. These engines have been used since 1981, although they've been upgraded, improving performance and saving NASA money. They're also hugely reliable. Between ground tests and shuttle flights, they've already clocked over 1 million seconds of hot fire time, and that's before SLS ever lifts off. So NASA has built some pretty incredible vehicles. But the Space Shuttle couldn't leave low Earth orbit, and the Saturn V only went to the moon. How will the SLS combine their capabilities and get to Mars? It's because, even though the SLS is built on previous technology, NASA's improved it. Think about your phone. This phone from 2007 looks a lot like this new one, and they do the same basic job. However, this one has more power, is more efficient, and can plain just do more thanks to improvements in technology. Similarly, the first version of the SLS will weigh 1 million pounds less than the Saturn V, but it'll get to the moon. The second version will weigh as much as the Saturn V. It'll carry the same amount of fuel, but it's far more fuel efficient, and that's the key to getting to Mars. Technology has changed a lot since the shuttle program began back in 1972. Back then, this was considered a smartphone. To sum up, the physics of sending a rocket into space haven't changed, but our engineering has. NASA has figured out how to build on legacy technology while also improving it. It's like putting a roof on the house. And when you do that, you don't tear out the foundation. Thanks for watching No Small Steps. See you next time.